لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا.
الحمد لله الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا، صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إلا تنصروه فقد نصره الله إذ أخرجه الذين كفروا ثاني اثنين إذ هما في الغار إذ يقول لصاحبه لا تحزن إن الله معنا، صدق الله العظيم. Respected viewers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. In our last program on the life of our beloved Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we spoke about Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's migration and the earlier stages of his migration. How he left Makkah Mukarrama undetected, how he joined Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, who was given the glad tidings of joining Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the incident with regard to that, how they came into the cave of Thor, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealing the ayat that when the second of the two, Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, told unto his companion, and Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told this to Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, at such a time when Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu saw the people of Makkah on the foot of the cave, and he said, Ya Rasulullah, we have been found out. They are going to harm us. And at that particular time, Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam remained unperturbed. Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam still had conviction in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Firm conviction. La tahzan. O Abu Bakr, do not grieve. Allah is with us. Look at the conviction of our beloved Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The greatest human being created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he consoled Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala. La tahzan. Inna Allah ma'ana. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had also made this aspect that a spider had brought about its web across the cave after they had entered the cave. And at that particular time, there had been a dove that had laid its eggs on the foot of the cave. So the people of Makkah thought that if anyone would have been in the cave, the web of the spider would have been disturbed. And the dove would not have laid its eggs here. This was a miracle from Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For our beloved Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for the protection of our beloved Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nevertheless, after 3 days, Abdullah bin Ariqat, who was hired by Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to lead the path towards Medina Munawwara, comes at the foot of the cave. Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left Makkah Mukarrama on Thursday. Monday morning, Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam leaves the cave to go towards Medina Munawwara and to start off this epic journey of migration. Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with Abu Bakr, Abdullah bin Ariqat, and one riwayat says Amir bin Fuhaira, the freed slave of Abu Bakr, and one riwayat makes mention of Abdullah bin Abu Bakr. 4 or 5 people live in this direction. Now keep in mind, the people of Makkah, when they had missed the opportunity to kill Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as was decided upon in Darun Nadwa by the Quraysh, they now announce a booty of 100 camels. 100 camels that time was tremendous amount of wealth. Anyone bringing Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam dead or alive would be given 100 camels. So people went into different direction. A person who was very well known in detection, very understanding of the terrain around Makkah Mukarrama, was Suraqa bin Malik. Suraqa bin Malik pursues Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he comes upon Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Before that, let me also make mention that when Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was leaving Makkah Mukarrama, there was a fork in the path, where on one way you go back to Makkah and one way you continue out of Makkah. At that time, Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked towards that fork, looked towards the direction of Makkah Mukarrama, and he said, "Oh Makkah," he addressed the beloved city of Makkah and said, "Had it not been for this reason that my people and my clan had forced me out of Makkah, I would not have left." And of course, there is a difference of opinion with regard to the holiest and most blessed city. Most of the ulama of the view that collectively, Makkah Mukarrama is more blessed than Medina Munawwara. However, the part of earth which is adjacent to the body of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that our ulama and scholars have said is even more blessed than Makkah Mukarramah. But collectively as a city, Makkah Mukarramah is more blessed than Medina Munawwara. Nevertheless, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam continues. Suraqa bin Malik, in pursuit of the 100 camels booty, comes upon Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And when he sees Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he dashes towards Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam makes dua. Suraqa bin Malik's horse goes down into the ground. And it goes down into the ground. And in that particular way, it is stuck. It is jammed. And then he realizes this is a miracle of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He calls out and says, "Oh Muhammad, I know this is because of your doing. You are a very powerful person. You make dua that Allah Ta'ala takes me out of this situation." And Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam makes dua for him. And then when he comes out, again he tries. After all, you know, it is money. And we know for the sake of money, what will people do? You know, and again he comes against Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, makes dua. For 3 times he makes this type of effort to try and gain and come and get that booty by arresting or taking Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam back to Makkah Mukarramah. And then Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells him, "Suraqa, what are you worried about? What are you worried about 100 camels? A time will come when Allah Ta'ala will grant victory to the Muslims over the Persian Empire. And oh Suraqa, if you accept Islam, I will write and I will give this particular notice now that the jewelry and some of the aspects of the treasures of the Persian Empire will come your way." I sometimes wonder that when we start reading management books and we don't take lessons from the beloved of Allah, we read in management books that be always positive and always look at the bright side of things. Despite what is happening to you, always don't be negative, be positive. And look at this example. Where can we get a better example? He is leaving the city of Makkah. There is a booty out against him for 100 camels if anyone brings him dead or alive. And that time when someone is pursuing him, he tells him, "What are you worried about? A time will come when the Persian Empire will collapse in front of my message." Can there be anything more positive than that? Where are we heading? Where do we take directions? Where do we take inspirations if we can't take inspiration from the greatest human being ever created by Allah? Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam continues in his journey. And then when Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam comes to a place by an old woman who had a very sparse tent that was there by the name of Umm Ma'bad radiyallahu ta'ala anha. May Allah fill her qabr with nur also. How she helped the Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam comes. They are hungry. There is no food in that house. The sheep had gone to graze. And at that particular time, Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam comes and asks Umm Ma'bad, "Do you have anything that you can entertain us with?" She expressed regret that she doesn't have anything. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam sees a very thin and frail goat. And Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Do you allow me to take out milk from that goat?" Umm Ma'bad said, "What is that goat going to give you?" Because of its weakness, it did not go and graze with the other goats and sheep. "But whatever you want to, if you can take out something from there, go, by all means, go and do it." Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam passes his Mubarak hands over the udders of that goat, and that goat starts filling up with milk until a container full of milk comes out of that thin and frail goat. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam drinks. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam allows his companions to drink, and Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam leaves behind something from Umm Ma'bad and her husband Abu Ma'bad. Abu Ma'bad comes back and said, "What is this container of milk? Where did you get it from?" And she relates the incident of what had happened. And some riwayat mention is made where she speaks about the appearance of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Such a person had come, full of nur. He had such great appearance. He had such great radiance. And she gives a description of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Abu Ma'bad says, "This is the same person whom the Quraysh are pursuing. I will one day go and present myself to him to accept Islam." And then Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam leaves us. Suraqa bin Malik's incident, Umm Ma'bad's incident, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam continues. And then on the way, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam met Buraida al-Aslami Buraidah al-Aslami also comes in pursuit of Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he comes in pursuit, he had 70 riders with him. And then when he comes and approaches Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam makes dua and he cannot come nearer. But there is some form of communication. Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asks him, "Oh, what is your name?" He said, "Buraidah." Buraidah means bird, which means cool. So Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it was a sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, always used to take good omens from any situation. So Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then told Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, "Look, his name is Buraidah, which means cool. That means our anxieties will be cooled." Then Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Oh Buraidah, from which tribe are you from?" So he said, "I'm from Bani Aslam." Aslam means safety. So Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep us safe." Now we have tribes, and then from the tribes, you have different branches of a tribe. So Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Oh Buraidah, you're from Bani Aslam. Which branch of Bani Aslam?" So he said, "Bani Saham." And Saham means share. So he said, "That means you will also share in Islam." And Buraidah al-Aslam is seeing the remarkable conduct of Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, accepts Islam. And those are also part of the delegation now that makes its way towards Medina Munawwara. And we will continue, inshallah, after the break. Respected viewers, welcome back once again to our program. Just before the break, we were speaking of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam continuing his journey towards Medina Munawwara and the migration from Makkah to Medina. And at that particular time, Buraidah al-Aslami radiallahu anhu's incident we made mention just before the break. And then Buraidah, with his 70 people, also joins what we will say the qafla, the delegation. And at that particular time, Buraidah said, "Ya Rasulullah, you know, the people will be waiting for you. Why don't you have a flag with which we will announce your arrival?" So Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam takes out his turban and gives it to Buraidah, who puts it on a long stick, and they continue. And that particular time, the people of Medina Munawwara used to come on the outskirts of Medina Munawwara to welcome Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They used to come in the early hours of the morning. And many a times when they didn't find Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because the news had filtered through that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have left Makkah. So they used to come. And then many a times they used to return back at home disappointed that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not come. And one day, as they were returning, one Jewish person who was on a mountain saw Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with his companions, with the people, the riders of Buraidah al-Aslami, who had brought Iman while coming on the way with Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saw the small delegation coming. And he said, "Ya Bani Qila, hadha jaddukum." Oh Bani Qila. Bani Qila was one of the mothers of the Aus and Khazraj, the mother, great-grandmother of the Ansar. And he said, "Oh Bani Qila, your source of good fortune has come." And the people of Medina and the people of Quba, they burst upon Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to give Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a remarkable welcome. Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stayed first in Quba. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Bakr were hosted by Amr bin Auf and Kulthum bin Haddam. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stayed there because Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wanted to establish himself outside Medina. Let the people of Medina get ready for the coming of Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So for 15 days, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam remained in Quba. And at that particular time, Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam put up Masjid al-Taqwa. La masjidun ussisa ala al-taqwa min awwali yawmin ahaqqu an taquma fihi rijalu yuhibbuna ayyata taharu wallahu yuhibbul muttahirin. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says the masjid which was established on the basis of taqwa. In there are people who are very clean-hearted. People who love cleanliness. The cleanliness is both physical and spiritual and by heart. Physical, they were extremely careful with regard to istinja. See into it that impurities do not touch their bodies. Allah ta'ala has made mention of it in the Holy Quran. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make an explanation of the ayat that they used to keep themselves free from impurities. And also clean-hearted. Also people who were clean towards other people. Allah Ta'ala has made mention, Allah Ta'ala loves those who are clean, both in physical sense and the spiritual sense. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam remained there for 15 days, put up what is known as Masjid al-Taqwa or the Masjid al-Quba. And then Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, after remaining there for some 2 weeks, Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, after remaining there and himself being part and parcel of the construction of the Masjid al-Quba, after that Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam makes his way to Madinah al-Munawwarah. It is a Jumu'ah. And this is where the first Jumu'ah takes place. Many Hujjaj would know that when you go out for Ziyarah, you come to a place which is known as the place where the tribe of Bani Salma used to stay. And it is said that this was the way the first Jumu'ah took place. From Quba to Madinah, Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wasallam comes, and Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wasallam stopped at the time of just after Zawal to make the first Jumu'ah, the first Jumu'ah Salat. And then Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wasallam gives a khutbah, in which Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wasallam gives great amount of emphasis upon taqwa, upon the fear of Almighty Allah, doing and obeying the commands of Allah, staying away from disobedience out of the fear of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah ta'ala make us amongst those who follow the commands of Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Make us amongst those who follow the advices of our beloved Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wasallam. You know, this was the first Jummah. Although Ka'b bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala used to say that before Hijrat, when Islam was introduced to Medina by Mus'ab bin Umair radiallahu ta'ala anhu, then at that particular time, they used to come, and when they used to come, and they wanted to do a day of congregation, to pray Salat in congregation. So Asad bin Zurara, out of his own initiative and his own inference, chose the day of Friday. So Ka'b bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu, on the day of Friday, when thereafter, when Allah Ta'ala made Friday the day of congregation and the day of superiority amongst other days of the week, then Ka'b bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu used to pay tribute to Asad bin Zurara radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He said that he, on his own inference, before Hijrat, he used to congregate and make some form of prayer on Friday, although it was made for us on this particular time when Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam was leaving Quba, coming to Medina al-Munawwarah. And then when Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam came into Medina al-Munawwarah, what can we say with regard to the happiness of the people of Medina? Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu used to say, there never was a day more joyful for the people of Medina than the day when Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam entered into Medina al-Munawwarah. And there was never a day which was greater calamity for the people of Medina than the day when our beloved Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wasallam departed from Medina al-Munawwarah, when he passed away. And when he came, then of course we know that the small girls of Medina al-Munawwarah started singing this beautiful poem, which up to this day has always remained a poem which brings about glory and happiness amongst the ummah. What is amazing is, despite all our differences, this particular poem, I have seen it read in all different sections of the Muslim Ummah. People who are regarded to be Sufis, Salafis, Khankahi, people who have all of them in every different branch and different situations of the Muslim Ummah, I have seen people taking delight in making mention of this most beautiful poem. Tala al-Badru alayna min thaniyatil wada'i. وجب الشكر علينا ما دعا لله داعي أيها المبعوث فينا جئت بالأمر المتاع. That the full moon has glowed upon us from the valley of Wada. How many people have sang this most beautiful nazam? That the people of Medina sang in welcoming our beloved Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then the small girls of Bani Najjar, who were also related to Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam from the maternal side, they then sang this beautiful poem. Nahnu jawarim min Bani Najjari, ya habbada Muhammadin min jari. We are the small girls of Bani Najjar, and we are fortunate that the Nabi of Allah would now be our neighbor. Ya Allah, what great joy was this! Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam comes to Medina al-Munawwarah, and when Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam comes to Medina al-Munawwarah, everyone wants to host Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, my camel has been commanded and instructed by Allah to stop at a place where Allah wills. And then the camel comes and stops at a small landing, at a small piece of land near the house of Abu Ayyub Ansari radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Abu Ayyub Ansari radiallahu ta'ala anhu comes out of his house to welcome Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For him was a good fortune that he was going to be the host of Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For 7 months Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stayed in his house. What a fortunate human being that he was to host Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is one riwayat which is made mention that many years before, one of the leaders of Yemen known as Tubba went with a group of ulama. He was a very pious ruler of Yemen. And Allah has made mention of him in the Holy Quran also. So he came with 400 ulama. And when they passed Medina Munawwara, the ulama said, from our divine scriptures, this looks to be the land where the last prophet of Almighty Allah would come. So Tubba, the leader of Yemen, given the fact that he was a pious person, purchased some homes to leave some of the ulama who wanted to remain there. And he also purchased a house for Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, this is a house I will leave for the last prophet when he comes to migrate to this place. And he left a letter that when he comes, this will be my letter towards him. Give him my letter. So when Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam came into the house of Abu Ayyub Ansari radiallahu anhu, Abu Ayyub Ansari radiallahu anhu was the grandchild from that particular progeny. And some riwayats made mention he presented that letter of the very famous and very pious king by the name of Tubba to Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was hosted by Abu Ayyub Ansari radiallahu anhu, but in a way, in a house that was purchased for him many, many years back. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, also we are indebted to Abu Ayyub Ansari radiallahu anhu. How he hosted Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, look at his respect. Look at the honor that he granted to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Ya Rasulullah, you have come to my house. I would like you to stay on the upper floor. Me and Umm Ayyub, we will stay on the bottom floor. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no, you stay on the top floor because people will be coming and going to come and meet me. You would be disturbed if you stay on the bottom floor. So then he agreed upon it. But the first night came, all of a sudden the thought came, I'm on top of the Nabi of Allah. I am staying on the upper floor. Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is at the bottom. Ya Allah, what have I done? In that particular way, he sits on the side of the railing so that he is not thinking that I must not be immediately on top of Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Next morning when he said, Ya Rasulullah, I can't stay on top. What's the reason? Ya Rasulullah, I'm sitting on top. I'm going to intervene in divine wahi coming down upon you. Abu Ayyub, this doesn't happen. You still stay on top. It's more convenient for you to stay on top. Abu Ayyub continued staying. Then one day there was an incident. Water jug that they had, it dropped and the water started coming upon the floor of the upper floor. So because those floors were, of course, very thin, there was a fear that it could start leaking down upon Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to cause him inconvenience. Abu Ayyub and Umm Ayyub they didn't have much, they only had one blanket. They started soaking that water so that it does not come down upon Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The next morning he said, Ya Rasulullah, I can't stay on top. Irrespective of the inconvenience, you go and stay on top. I find it against respect to stay on the upper floor while you are on the lower floor. This was not to do with halal and haram. This was from the heart. This was respect. In this way, our beloved Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam completes his journey from Makkah to Medina, known as a hijrat. Inshallah, in our next program, we will look upon the reasons why our Islamic calendar starts off from this event. May Allah give you another tawfiq of understanding the greatness of the life of our beloved Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa akhiru da'wana الحمد لله رب العالمين.
لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا.